Welcome back to Eddie's Audio. Here we have a 7-CD disc changer from TEAC. I picked this up just laying on the ground at the recycling center. Somebody had discarded it, probably because they're into streaming now or heavily into vinyl or something else. And you don't see many CD videos now. CDs, I guess, are out of vogue. Who knows? But one of the things that this machine had as a problem was the drawer was a little bit sticky. It wouldn't open and close very good, but I fixed that. I just moved it in and out a lot of times, and I, you know, exercised the gears, and that seemed to cure the problem. You know, when mechanical devices like this lay around, you know, sometimes they need a little bit of coaxing to get working when they're idle. So anyway, it's the PD -H570. Pretty cool looking unit. Here's the front panel. Oddly enough, when the power is off, the light is on. I don't know why. That's kind of a weird thing. When you put the power on, the light goes off. Does that make any sense to you guys? Above it is the remote sensor. Sadly, I don't have the remote. Nice, heavy, gold tone, metal faceplate. Nice big drawer opening there. A really quality feeling unit. Got the open and close, disc skip, stop, play, and pause. You don't have a, it does have a next track buttons. But anyway, what I was going to say is this is not a carousel CD changer. It's a drawer type changer, and it works by moving the CDs up and down vertically rather than in a carousel fashion. Let me show you the back. Is the back panel here. And you can see it's made in Korea. You can pause that and read all that cool stuff if you want. Oddly enough, it has two optical outputs. I don't know why you would need two. I have it hooked up to the RCA outputs. And you got some kind of remote connector to connect it to the matching tuner or matching amplifier, excuse me. A nice, I don't want to touch this because it's plugged in. You get a nice blast of 120 volts there, but fuse power supply, got some heat sinks. I mean, it's a quality unit. Big hefty transport. Well, it is a changer. I clean the laser with a little bit of alcohol on a Q-tip, but it didn't really improve it. There was nothing wrong with it anyway. So, we'll get a better view here. Is there enough lighting here? Yeah, I think there's enough light. Let me get this towards the window. It's a beautiful day outside. And I'm here down the cellar. That's my ladder on the window there. I'm down the cellar here. It's a beautiful day. And, I'm down here in the basement screwing around my audio stuff. I'm going to go outside and get some fresh air after this. So here we go. It came with 7 CDs in it. Oh, by the way, I have it hooked up to this little Sony, Bluetooth speaker. But you can also put a hardwired deal in there, too. I think it's the XBS-20, which has been replaced by the XBS-21. But, you know, these little speakers are very impressive. You know, they're not bad sounding. This I got on Amazon as a refurbished. If you ever check out Amazon's refurbished electronics, a lot of times they're better than new because they go over them really good before they send them out again. But anyway, getting back to this. Came with 7 CDs in it. Let's load them up. All right, and they're all Spanish CDs. I like Spanish music. I don't speak Spanish, but I like Spanish music. What is this? Vincent Fernandez, and we got here Marin Hits 2001. Oh, so let me show you how this works. So you put a disc in, and you push disc skip, and it loads the disc in the mechanism, and then it brings the draw out for the next disc. Marin Hits 2001. your disc it. All right, next we got Classicas de Classic. Classic of Classics, I guess. I don't know. All right, disc it. Next we got one called Charlie Zaa, Z-A-A. I don't know who that is. And if you notice here, as we load them up, you can see in the dial here on the display. I'll show you that in a second. Next. Disc number 6, Latin Grammys 2001. And next, Marin Hits, 1997. All right, so there's 7 in there. Now it should hit the close instead of the disc skip. All right, so now you can see there's 7 circles there. That means there's 7 discs in it. It holds 7. It's not on disc number 1 because I just hit the disc skip after it was loaded up, so it went to 2. Or is that 3? Let me see here. It's hard to see. Oh, whatever disc is on, we're going to hear. All right, so here we go. This is, now I'm not going to play too much of each track, but you can get the idea. One of the things that was impressive about this is it has a really quick access. Oops, hit the wrong button. Hit the play. Watch how quick it accesses the tracks. That's pretty quick, right? It's funny, you got a tuba in that, and it sounds like an accordion in the background. It's almost like German music. It sounds like at the beginning. Let's do a disc skip, see what happens here. Pretty quick access. That was pretty quick. It changes from one disc to another really quick. Let's try it again. Watch how quick it is to change to a new disc. Disc number 6 now.
This song is for you, wherever you are.
Well, some English. All right, I'll do the disc skip so you can see how fast it goes from up here. Quick, right? I like this CD. I don't know what this is. Yeah, this is a nice sounding one. I'm gonna see what this is. Oh, this is that Charlie Zaa. It's a nice sounding disc. Quick access. Sounds like real strings. Disc skip. It's going to disc one now. I think we started with disc four, right? Anyway, there it is, the TX 7CD changer. Pretty quality unit. It has the optical output, so I can try it on a DAC sometime. It probably sounds even better through a DAC and a big stereo system. Thanks for watching, guys. Over and out.